Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. It's Gabriel, and in today's video, we have a special guest coming on to talk about another job that I would want to, give you guys exposure to, which is being a registered health information administrator. I just want, want to ask Juliette a few questions regarding this career. Hopefully it will, help you guys out in terms of career options apart from just Epic. Juliette, thank you for coming out to the channel. If you want to just introduce yourself, just tell us who you are, what you do.
Hi, everyone. My name is Juliette. I do a couple of things. I wear a few hats here and there. I currently teach at UT Austin in the health IT cert program. So if you are trying to get your foot into the door, then it's a really great 9-week program. I also monitor operate my own personal business where I help health IT professionals gain their certifications as well as just gaining more knowledge. The RHIA actually is one of the certifications that is available out there for health IT professionals if they want to show their stuff in the industry. So that is my wheelhouse as of right now.
Great. Awesome, Juliette. How would you say, like, if I, would you be like I'm a RHIA professional? How would you describe yourself?
Yeah, so it's kind of similar to what you're doing with Epic, like you're saying that you're Epic certified. Mm-hmm. Someone can be RHIA certified. And so RHIA stands for Registered Health Information Administrator. And what this examination test is the test taker's knowledge and being able to manage patient data. So the RHIA certification is not really directed to one role. There are various roles that someone can do and have the certification, but you're just showing that, hey, I understand compliance. I understand the importance of databases, how to use databases. I understand there's so many things, data visualization. I understand project management. All these things are tested in this one exam. So that is really what it is.
Do you need a bachelor's degree to, sit in for the RHIA exam examination?
First off, you have to be educated with either a bachelor's degree, or if you end up getting your master's in health IT in the future, a master's degree from a school, and not just any school. It has to be a CAPM accredited school. CAPM accredited schools, CAPM is a organization that helps with standardization, curriculum, et cetera. So they have their own footprint of what classes and courses make sense in order to get the certification. So if you get your degree in health informatics, but it's not from one of these CAPM schools, you don't qualify to take it. And I've broken some hearts when I told them that. So if you want to do this in the future, if you're like, okay, that sounds cool, make sure that you are attending a CAPM school. How do you check that? CAPM does have a website where you can actually search and see by state, by type of degree, whether or not your school actually qualifies for that examination.
What is the day-to-day responsibilities like for someone in your role?
So it varies. So the RHIA certification is really more so slated for anyone that is in the health IT space. There isn't a specific job role per se. It's kind of like getting your LVN or your RN certification. You can be working in pediatrics, you can be working in cardiology. It's just saying that you have the knowledge and you understand how to manage data. So the day in life of a RHIA professional may be that they are in compliance and they are, monitoring providers and making sure that they are doing the right things legally. You may be in charge of CDI, so clinical documentation improvement. So maybe you are noticing that there's a nurse that does not initial something, and you have to go there and say, "Hey, nurse Betty, Can you please, you know, like look at these files because you forgot to sign them? Maybe you're doing, maybe you are the HIM director and you have a team of people that you're working over, and your job is to go to meetings and make important decisions about what the hospital is going to do in terms of this upcoming Epic implementation. Like, you're responsible for getting that set up. So as far as what they do, there's so many things. Yeah, there's so many different avenues.
Gotcha, gotcha. So you mentioned Epic in there. So how, like, often do you, would you guys use an EHR in your current role? Like, is it like, you know, 30% of the time? Is it like 90% of the time, all the time?
Yeah, so it really just depends on the role, but technology is a big part of health IT. We are there for technology, and EHRs is everywhere, obviously. So EHRs is a big part, not just with managing the EHR itself, but also the integrations that are connected to it. The patient portal, the HIE, if they have that. I'm just thinking off the top of my head, if there's any type of, I don't know, any type of like X-ray or dictation, dragon, or whatever that's going on, there's someone that's responsible for ensuring that things are running smoothly, that policy is being followed, that patient data is protected and it's not being captured by hackers. Even something even something as far as security, there are people that are RHIA certified and they are a part of the security aspect of the hospital. It really varies, to be honest. There is no one role to this certification.
What kind of like career growth and opportunities is there for someone with the certification?
Yeah, there is a major career growth. There are actually some positions where you can't even do the job unless you have the certification. So similar to the Epic credential, if you don't have a RHIA certification, you can lose your job. I've had students that have joined my prep course where they are there because they have 2 months to pass this exam. If not, they are going to lose their job. I'm not saying all jobs require this certification, but it's found mostly in hospital roles. There are some roles where they want someone that's RHIA certified because it proves that they understand how to manage data and just understand the theory behind what's going on in their day-to-day jobs.
It seems like you guys use data a lot. Do you guys work with like SQL or Python and things like that? Or
yeah,
how often do you guys use that?
It would depend on the person. So if there's someone that is working in the hospital and I'm just spitballing, I don't know, some type of application analyst, I don't know, I'm throwing stuff out, but I'm sure that there are analyst roles out there and just other positions where they work at a hospital, they are doing coding, maybe a database administrator, I don't know, something like that. Those people, if they went to school and got their bachelor's or their master's in health IT and they wanted to take their RHIA, they could take their RHIA and still be using those coding skills.
So every career has its challenges and rewards. So what would you say are some of the biggest challenges you face as a RHIA professional?
Yeah, so I would say one of the biggest challenges with being RHIA certified is keeping that certification. Just like any other certification, you have to maintain it. You have to be a lifelong learner. And this, with the certification, that's the requirement. You have to go to webinars and you have to, you know, go to conferences and gain your CEUs and pay that membership fee. So people are like, oh yeah, I want to get the certification, but it sounds great. It looks great on your resume. But if you want to maintain that, you do have maintenance fees and, you know, educational requirements that are a part of it. And that's, to me, it's not difficult, but I would say it's one of the pains of it. You're like, ooh, I love being RHIA certified, but I have to spend all this money now to keep this certification. So I would say that.
And what do you find most rewarding about, you know, the kind of work, you know, as a RHIA professional, the work that you do?
So before I became self-employed and started kind of working for myself, when I was working with actual, provider offices and things like that, I just loved the ability to help a provider that would on, because I was, just for background, I did implementation management. I was a project manager in health IT. That was my bread and butter. So I did that for about 10 years and that was all I did. So I traveled to different hospitals, similar to like a Epic credential trainer. I would travel and teach people how to use EHR systems wherever I was working at that time, and different things like that. So the pleasure of seeing someone that hated technology, maybe was 70 years old, was a provider that was so used to paper, and now is being forced because of the High Tech Act to now have to use an EHR system and use technology, drove them crazy. I had someone actually throw a chair out the window because he was so upset. So having someone that's that upset go from that state to clicking and actually happy and excited to have just five clicks to get something done and being able to send a direct message to, you know, to their provider friend in a different state in seconds versus faxing was amazing. So that was the pleasure that I got for me now in my career as a business owner of RHIA Essential. My pleasure is now in seeing my students passing their exams, seeing them frustrated, nervous, and then writing me and saying, "Hey, I've passed." And just kind of building and creating and adding more RHIA people into this world because we need them. That is my pleasure right now.
What made you transition into, you know, being the business owner from, you know, having been a RHIA professional? What was that transition like? And what like triggered that?
Yeah. So I think for me, I had a chance to teach, and in teaching, I just found a lot of pleasure in teaching. And so it just kind of made sense to me and say, you know what, I'm doing this on the side. Let me go ahead and just kind of bet on me and just, you know, do this full time, give more time to my students, because it's hard to balance two things at one time, especially, you know, providers and people need their stuff done, right? And then you're trying to help a student. It just became kind of a conflict. And then also just future, just kind of depending on family too. I wanted to be able to, you know, focus on my fiance, be able to focus on just my future, and just wanted to just have more time to just kind of to myself. And I'm sure he appreciates it too. That was kind of my reasonings for jumping into entrepreneurship. It's definitely a lot different than the 9-to-5, but it was just a decision that at this point I knew made sense for me.
Yeah, we don't have like, it's kind of rare to see someone, you know, take that leap of faith and go into, you know, entrepreneurship, like you said, very, very inspiring, honestly. And any advice for any aspiring RHIA professionals who are interested in pursuing this as a career, what advice would you give them?
I would tell them, if you're in school right now and you are a senior or a second year, if you're taking your master's and you're gonna take this exam, please take it as soon as you finish school, because as soon as you leave with each and every, it's kind of similar to a car. Your car is worth so much money when you're at the car lot, but as soon as you drive off, the value of your car dies every single day. And it's kind of similar to the RHIA knowledge. You're like, the information is going to be so strong and so prominent in your head in that moment. But as you step away from school and you're thinking about finding a job and this and that, you're kind of losing that information that you learned back in your sophomore year. So take it as soon as you can. And for those that are planning to take this exam and they've been out of school for 5-10 years, I've had plenty of successes with that too. Just know that you can still pass this exam. Just take it one day at a time. start from taking a practice exam, see how well you do, find your faults, and then study that information. You can do it. You just have to push yourself with anything else.
Who do you recommend should like go into this career? What kind of person, like what kind of skills or qualities should they possess to be successful in this career as a RHIA professional?
Yeah, so the RHIA credential is not for everybody. So what I always say is, if you're like, okay, should I do this or not? Look at the type of roles that you're interested in. If you're trying to become a consultant, and then maybe getting this, you know, credential doesn't really make sense for you. If you're planning to work in the hospital and you're going to be dealing with data heavy, like heavy data use, then this may be something that you want to consider. I always tell people, go to LinkedIn or Indeed or whatever that you use, type in the job role that you want to do, look at those preferences that they have, because they always have preferences of who they're looking for. Look on there. If you see for licenses or credentials, RHIA, RHIT, there's so many, but if you see RHIA or RHIT, then know that you probably want to take or consider getting that credential if you qualify.
But you mentioned that you have your own business helping students with their RHIA professional certificate. Do you have anything to plug in? Where can people find you if they need help?
Yeah, so I am all over social media. I try to be there as much as possible. So how to find me? So I do have a YouTube channel. It is called the Health IT Playground. And the purpose of this channel and the reason why I made this is kind of what started my whole journey here, was the channel is there to help educate current and future health IT professionals about the industry. For those that are here that are watching that know about health IT, you also know that we are not known by a lot of people. People figure out about health IT on accident, which is something that I despise. And so it was my goal to find a way to educate people and provide more awareness about health IT. So that was the reason why, my reasoning of making this channel. And so I do a lot of things on the channel. I have interviews where I talk to professionals about what they're doing to showcase what's out there and available. I do, of course, RHIA and RIT exam prep information for those that want to take it. I also am working on CAPM and PMP information. I am certified in that as well. That was my bread and butter. So if you want to get that certification and you're trying to figure out how that fits into health IT, I'm your girl. Check out the channel. And I just have loads of health IT stuff. I do fish from time to time, so you may see some random videos of me just fishing. So choose to ignore those if you want to, but I do like to fish. But outside of that, outside of my hobbies, those are things that I have on the channel. Outside of that, I have a business. If you are watching and you are qualified to take the RHIA and you're considering getting some exam prep and you want to invest in yourself is how I say it, then I do offer that as well. Check out RHIAessential.com to see our on-demand courses available. And yeah, and then also for those that don't want to pay, I do have Insight Tuesday, every Tuesday, where I spend 30 minutes educating about a concept on the RHIA exam for those that just want to get a little nugget here and there and study on their own, because you don't have to pay money to pass, okay? But some people need it, and I'm here for those that need it.
Thank you, Julia. That was such valuable information that you gave out to my subscribers here. I know a lot of people, don't necessarily have to want to go into Epic, and just want to tell them that there are different routes that they can take. Like you mentioned, RHIA is a route they can possibly take as well. And I appreciate all your insights, Julia. Thank you so much for being on the channel, and hopefully we can have you in the future as well.
Yes, thank you for having me. And please check him out, because he's going to be on my channel too. And I hope that he plugs it. I know he will. So you guys check him out on the Health IT Playground for those that want to learn more about his journey, because it's really cool.
I will plug everything, all her information in the description below, guys. Just one click away. We'll take you right to her. All right, thank you, guys.
All right. Thank you.